EA Sports and the PGA Tour are proud to bring you this showcase of the best young players in the world of golf. From Bay Hill Club and Lodge in Orlando, Florida, third round coverage of Q School. Rich Lerner here in our tower overlooking the 18th green. Frank Navolo is by my side. Out on the course, we've got Nota Begay III and Iona Stephen as we check the Saturday leaderboard. We've currently got a tie at the top at 5 under par. Included among them is our featured golfer, who we'll be following intently throughout the round. And that a wonderful tee shot. It's in the fairway here to get this Saturday started. What you need to watch out for here, Frank?
Those two front bunkers, Rich, the one that protects the left and the right. More often than not, you want to pitch the ball in the front of this green. They are the two to be concerned about.
Oh, is that any good? Perfect.
That was tracking pretty well, too. That could have gone in for the same price.
Okay, that's in for par here at the first. And he'll stay at 5 under.
Line may have been a little more sunken in than we had thought, but all in all, not a bad shot out of the bunker.
Right about 9 feet here to the hole.
Oh,
Matt, that was right all the way. Okay, it's a bogey here at the second. And he's going to fall out of the lead and wind up a shot back. Good shot coming off bogey at the second. That's going to be in the fairway. Second shot coming up. Let's check in for the first time with Notovegay the third.
146 yards left to the hole, coming off a bogey on the previous hole. Got to get it back here.
Well, had a good look at the green, but couldn't cash it in the rough now, wondering what might have been. Just gonna sneak on by. That one in for a bogey here at the third. And he's gonna fall to three shots off the lead. Beautiful tempo to that swing, and this is going to wind up squarely in the fairway. I'm not sure he got every bit of that three wood trying to get home to this par five and two, but still in the ball game for a birdie.
Two good shots on this par five, leaves that simple little chip, and that was beautifully played.
A straightforward look here for birdie. Not much to that. It is a birdie here at four, and he'll move to four under. Yeah, this is not the biggest of fairways, so that is a good shot here at five. Now, note his second from the fairway.
Looking at 104 yards to the front, 117 to the hole. Player has to contend with this left-to-right breeze. Sand wedge takes flight, and I don't think it's going to carry.
Well, he'll be disappointed with that, no doubt.
Yeah, swing didn't quite look right on that one.
Doesn't hurt to leave it short when you do that. Well done. That is a birdie from off the green. That challenged a big piece of that big lake, but it is well down this sixth fairway. What a gorgeous tee shot. That's what he wanted to do. After the tee shot, puts himself in a really good position here on the par five.
What a great shot. Could easily have gone in for the same price.
Oh, how about the run here? That a third consecutive birdie. And that's going to move him to six under par. Looking to splash this softly onto the green. maybe a little frustration there. Got a little too much sand and not enough golf ball, and that will come up quite a bit short. That's going to scoot a foot or two by. That one in. It is a bogey here at the seventh. He'll drop out of the lead. Wind up a shot back. Just what you want at this point in the round. You're trying to find a rhythm, hit fairways, hit the middle of the club face. That's what they did right there.
Second shot. Good look at the green.
That's going to need to go.
Well, the ball's finished up okay, but look how it got there.
Birdie putt coming up, and we go to Iona Stephen.
Yeah, and it would be easy to leave this one short because we're going back up that hill with just the slightest bit of movement from left to right.
Okay, that in for par here at the eighth. And he'll remain right where he is. Just over 160 yards still to go here for this second.
I imagine a missed club because that ball sailed past the flag. Really just fortunate to stay on the back of the green.
You got to think two putts will work out fine from here, but this is a long look for birdie.
It's in from long distance for birdie here at the ninth. And this will be a one under front side as he goes out in 35. No problems there. That's going to wind up safely in the fairway. So Iona, this his second from the fairway.
122 is the number. Pin tucked in the front left-hand portion of the green today.
Good chance at one.
Well, I don't have my tape measure out, but that looks like, I don't know what, 6-7 feet in there, but that is an excellent approach shot.
7 feet now for birdie. Yeah, that's good putt. A birdie here at one. And he's going to move to 7 under par, 2 under on the day. This is where club selection is so important. Second shot into that stiff breeze.
And a good approach shot, just not quite as close as what you'd like, but still solid.
a birdie putt here at the 11th.
Well, and he's had great conversion on putts like this. Even when he's not close to the hole, he's left himself with very makeable opportunities.
Got it there, but not quite on target. So that brushed in for par here at 11, and he's going to stay two clear of the field. Has to be thrilled with that second shot here to the par five. Frank got everything out of that.
Yeah, did well just to advance the ball so far down the fairway. And now a fairly straightforward third shot.
Feet still to go. Not that time. Pretty good effort, but it'll wander a couple of feet by. That one safely in. It's par here at 12. And this will remain a one-shot advantage. Well, you can't walk out and drop it any better than that. That is a fine tee shot right there. So after the big drive, this, a short approach to the par four. Okay, a little left to do, but safely on the green. That one just gonna sneak on by. Okay, safely in for par here at 13. And this will stay a one-shot lead. That will be too much club. It's into one of those two bunkers over the back of this 14th green.
Awkward little bunker shot. Just splash it out, let the ball run towards the flag.
That is a good-looking pass out of the bunker right there. Got that to stop in a good place, leaving just a few feet for par.
Okay, good putt. And a par here at 14. And he'll stay at 7-under. No issues here. That is into the fairway. So a breeze at his back as he readies his second to the par four.
And a good iron shot, just not quite as close as what we'd all want to finish, but still.
A look at birdie here at 15.
Yeah, I don't see a whole lot of break in this overall. Distance very important. It might be one of those putts. Hit it firm, you take the break out altogether.
Not from downtown. That in for a birdie here at 15. And that's going to move him to 8-under.
This one starting a little left off the tee. Nope. Okay, that'll be a par here at 16. He's going to hold on to that 3-shot lead. And this is going to be in the short grass just off to the left.
Way too good, I must say. That was just smashed. Man, the size of a putt left.
About 17 feet on this putt. Not quite online, and that'll drift a couple feet by. That one finished off for bogey here at 17. And that's going to tighten things up a little as the lead is down to 2. That will do just fine. 170 yards the distance needed here as he'll ready his second. So a tap in there, that's for par at the last. And this will be a third round score of 70 on this Saturday. So a two-stroke lead here for our featured golfer. That's good news, but you have to